With yet another semester looming to a close here at St. Bice's Institute of Media and Communication, today we decided to interview a bunch of students and ask them how they felt about their final year in college. Incidentally, it's also the last year, which means that it's specialization year, as in students who are bifurcated into communication and management and mass communication in their second year are then further bifurcated into their specialization streams in their third year. Today, we have the communication management students here with us to talk about their experiences of their penultimate semester in college. We have Gayatri Ilangovan from the advertising batch of the third year, Chitra Surana, who's also from the advertising batch, and we have Amar and Kunal, who are from the PR batch, and of course we have Khushbu, who's also from the advertising batch. Thanks so much for being with us at First Break here, guys. Thank you so much. Starting off, I'd like to ask you all, how has the specialization semester, the first of the two specialization semesters, been for you all? If we could start off with Kunal, that would be great.
It has been good. The study wasn't very focused. Now I'm into PR, so obviously the study is very focused and I'm getting insights of PR industry, how it's functioning. Many eminent personalities from this industry of PR coming into teachers. So it gives you a focused idea of the industry and the specialization, so hence makes easier for you to go in the industry and your next internship and make it good and possible for you to crack it.
All right, thank you so much. Amar, would you like to add to that?
I'd like to say that, as communication management students, the least we can expect from our own college management is good communication, and which I couldn't see, because what happened was, the modules and the timings, they were not planned properly at some level, maybe at the administration level. So yeah, that was lacking.
All right. Amar says there's a problem with the scheduling. Do you agree with that, Chitra?
I would like to contradict it rather, because the schedules and all, since we have visiting faculty, which is, they are professionals. So it actually depends on them and not on the college. They are working professionals and their schedules don't allow some time. I think the college, the semester has been brilliant so far. I like the subject. The only problem being design tech, as in design tech was awesome. I think that we should have more of it. Like sir himself was, he mentioned it last class, that designing as an aspect has not been touched upon, to the full extent in this college. So I think we should focus on that also, since we are in ad.
I would like to make a point here. I agree that there are restraints in management of college and institute, but as a student, when you see a very frequent change in the faculty, it somehow tends to get incoherent, the entire module, and you tend to get confused, because different teachers standing up have different opinions about the industry, different views about the subject. So that tends to, confuse the apprentices in a lot of manner.
On the practice side, you get to see all the sides of the coin. You get to see all the opinions.
But I think
at least what's good about our college is that they at least try to get in professionals from the industry. So you have an overall exposure and understanding about the industry. Everybody's got their own views. They share their opinions, which is a good thing.
We do have faculty members from BBA coming and teaching us, and we compare our faculty with theirs. Theirs is a very spoon-fed sort of method of teaching. Mm. They give us all the notes, they even give us a question bank and things like that, which normally we're not used to. So I believe
We'll come to that.
As Chitra mentioned, that we are lucky to have a range of opinions, a gamut of opinions with us, but I don't think third year is the right time for various opinions being bombarded at us, because we are already very confused as to how our careers will take the course in future. So I don't think this is the right time for faculty members.
Okay, so Emma says that the third year is not the right year to streamline your approach and have a varied opinion, rather than focus on certain things and get it done. Which takes us to the second question. Guys, let me ask you, what do you think of the modules you've had as students this time? I've heard of you mentioning a few. There was design technology mentioned. I've also heard you guys had market research as one of the subjects, and there was account planning, media planning, client servicing. You had event planning as a PR student. So how varied or how diverse were your subjects this semester compared to last year in communication management? Would you like to take that?
Yeah, I think this time it was more practical. because we did, I mean, client servicing, we didn't do anything theoretical, but we still did have a pitching session, which was a great way to learn. I mean, we'd never done a pitch before. I mean, even in our internships, we were not allowed to participate in them because they were confidential pitches. But this time we got a taste of it at least maybe a very basic one, but at least it was there. So I think that was great.
I'd like to make a point in here, like the kinds of subjects we had, the diversity in the subjects we had, is actually very good for us. Reason being, when you have accountancy, you have brand manager as well. A lot of us later in life, we want to open our own agency or like are willing entrepreneurs. So it's very important for you to know inside out accountancy. You want to know brand management also because you want to make your own child. Being in the future later. So obviously the kind of subjects we have, different fields and different areas of specialization, obviously it's very good for us, makes it more easy for us later in life when we are going ahead with our professionals to touch and brush up and improve other sectors connected to your mainstream as well. But one more point I'd like to make in here is, certain subjects in our entire module set, they were given more privilege, as in like we have a set pattern of assignments, we have a set pattern of class tests, but a subject like marketing, market research, we had around 20 assignments if I'm not wrong, maybe more than 20. So obviously this is not fair enough on the part of other subjects for one, and second, it overloads the student, overdose of market research. Obviously somewhere you start repelling it and then you don't feel like studying market research anymore, and then you feel like it's burdening me, it's harassing me, and then you start cursing the teacher. So obviously if there is a set pattern of 4 assignments, 1 class test, maybe 2 class tests, it should continue with all subjects, builds your interest in the subject, there has been some logic behind it, so you should not actually deviate from the...
To add to Kunal's point, yeah, I agree that there was a very, you know, a disbalance among the modules. Some were, you know, given a lot of prominence, others were totally neglected. MR, a lot of us would agree that should have been a completely new specialization altogether, while certain modules like event management, for example, the way it should have been treated wasn't treated that way, because event management is something very practical and expedient in nature, while it was made a very theory based as per our module this semester.
Add to the point that he mentioned that in market research we had a lot of assignments, and I agree to the point that it put too much pressure on the students, and as a fact that towards the end you kind of got a little tired of the subject and you didn't really focus much on your other subjects and the pressure was a lot. But you can't really also blame the college, because that's the way the teacher teaches. Every teacher has a different way of teaching, and her and Priya ma'am's way of teaching was giving assignments to everybody.
I would also like an assignment on each subject. Yeah. And one more thing, Priya ma'am herself asked that which way you want me to teach you, the PPT way or the practical way. We opted for it, so we can't really complain right now. Although I agree with their point that it was too much. At the end, even I was like frustrated that, you know.
I would.
Guys, now that we're talking about alternative teaching methods, we'll also come to the point of, you know, HRM, for instance. I've heard that in your HRM classes, she used some innovative techniques to teach you all. Do you think such an implementation is possible across all subjects, or do you think it is only limited to a few subjects?
Not all subjects, like numerical subjects, like statistics. I mean, those cannot be taught that way.
Even stats can be made fun. If you're actually willing to make a subject fun, it can be any subject, you can make it fun and have more effort.
Not even statistics, even in account planning. Our professor, he did try to make an effort that, you know, he told us, okay, look at balance sheets of companies, which is something
movies.
That we haven't
We saw some movies before. Like Ghapla and others, just to make the class and the concept concept interesting.
A better perspective on the stock market. It all depends, I think, maybe on the teacher as to how he wants to incorporate, you know, how is his teaching plan at the end
and
of the day.
And in statistics,
I would like to specify here is that teaching method is a totally different thing, and, you know, lack of vision is a different thing altogether. What happened in MR was a total lack of vision, or maybe it was planned or something. We were made to do a lot of assignments just for the promise that we would not have to take the external examinations. We did a lot of assignments on that basis, but ultimately what happens is that we have to take the external exams. So that is quite disheartening.
The final thing which he planned for us
transparency issues
didn't happen.
Because we don't know where our assignments are going. We're doing about 5 assignments per module at least. And we don't know are these being calculated or not. We are randomly doing assignments. It's like you mentioned, it's an overload. unnecessary overload, I should say.
And what Emma says is true, is that there is, like as she mentioned also, there's no clear transparency. It's like you tell us one thing, you're doing something else. The teacher should have that vision. The teacher should know how she wants to go ahead with the subject and how she wants to take it this entire semester.
There's just empty promises going around
exactly.
the campus.
And they should be a little careful as to not to burden us so much also. And it's not fair that it's only on one subject.
Can one of you wrap up for me?
Yeah, I'll try. See, the reason we put a question mark in front of college is that MR, like unlike other subjects, had too many assignments. We had no idea where assignments were going, which were evaluated, which were not evaluated. Makes it tough for your own self to judge yourself, your performance, for one. Second thing, we were given an option to how the teaching method should class be in the class be like PPT or like lectures. We opted for the second one, that was in class. But then burdening with assignments when we have a set pattern in college, that's actually not fair, because you have no idea where you are going and you have no idea where the module is going. So makes it very, very tough for you, for one. Second thing, innovative techniques, talking about innovative techniques in class. This time we actually had many innovative techniques like HR and accountancy. We were watching movies, we were playing games inside the classroom area. So obviously makes the learning fun, and plus, honestly speaking, what we learned from accountancy classes were little less than what we learned from the movies, if I'm not wrong.
So we can take an head count that any subject can be made innovative and fun. All right. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much for joining me here for First Break. We had Kunal sum it up for us. The thing is, a little bit of review is required when it comes to the teaching patterns adopted by the teachers here at SIMCUG, especially for the communication management segment. They seem to be young and bright, they seem to be enjoying the classes, and we seem to be having a great time putting it up for you. This is Abhinandan Sridhar signing off from First Break, along with Anugya Chitranj, who's the photographer. Thank you.